you're here. This is the headquarters of the Nightingales, cut into the mountainside by the first of our kind. We've come to seek the edge we need to defeat Mercer Frey. If you'll follow me, I'll try to explain on the way. This way, please.
So this is Nightingale Hall. I heard about this place when I joined the guild, but I never believed it existed.
I think we should trust the lass and take the deal.
You appear ready for the oath.
Time's wasted, and Mercer's still out there. Let's get this show on the road.
You appear ready for the oath. Proceed down the hall to the gate when you're ready.
The impression that we are not seeing this place at its best.
You appear ready for the oath.
Okay, lass. We've got these get-ups on. Now what?
Beyond this gate is the first step in becoming a Nightingale.
Whoa there, lass. I appreciate the armor, but becoming a Nightingale? That was never discussed.
To hold any hope of defeating Mercer, we must have Nocturnal at our backs. If she's to accept you as one of her own, an arrangement must be struck.
What sort of arrangement? I need to know the terms.
The terms are quite simple. Nocturnal will allow you to become a Nightingale and use your abilities for whatever you wish. And in return, both in life and in death, you must serve as a guardian of the Twilight Sepulchre.
Aye, there's always a catch. But at this point, I suppose there isn't much to lose. If it means the end of Mercer Frey, you can count me in.
What about you? Are you ready to transact the oath? By transacting the oath, you're free to use those powers as you see fit. In return, you'll be required to defend the Twilight Sepulchre and everything within when the need arises. More importantly, upon your death, your spirit will be bound to the Twilight Sepulchre as one of its guardians. Once the oath has been struck, the terms are binding. Knowing this, are you ready to undergo the ceremony? What about you? Good. After I open the gate, please stand on the western circle. Upon you, Lady Nocturnal, Queen of Murk and Empress of Shadow. Hear my voice.
Ah, Carlia. I was wondering when I'd hear from you again. Lose something, did we?
My lady, I've come before you to throw myself upon your mercy and to accept responsibility for my failure.
You're already mine, Carlia. Your terms were struck long ago. What could you possibly offer me now?
I have two others that wish to transact the oath, to serve you both in life and in death.
You surprise me, Carlyle. This offer is definitely weighted in my favor.
My appetite for Mercer's demise exceeds my craving for wealth and grace.
Revenge? How interesting. Very well. The conditions are acceptable. You may proceed.
Lady Nocturnal, we accept your terms. We dedicate ourselves to you as both your avengers and your sentinels. We will honor our agreement in this life and the next until your conditions have been met.
Very well. I name your initiates Nightingale, and I restore your status to the same, Carlyle. And in the future, I'd suggest you refrain from disappointing me again.
Now that you've transacted the oath, it's time to reveal the final piece of the puzzle to you. Mercer's true crop. Mercer was able to unlock the Guild's vault without two keys because of what he stole from the Twilight Sepulchre, the skeleton key. By doing this, he's compromised our ties to Nocturnal and, in essence, caused our luck to run dry. Well, yes. All of us possess untapped abilities. Once you realize the key can access these traits, potential becomes limitless. I'm afraid that's impossible. If the key isn't returned to its lock in the Twilight Sepulchre, things will never be the same for the Guild. As time passed, our luck would diminish to the point of non-existence. And whether you know it or not, our uncanny luck defines our trade. Very true. You know, before we depart, Brynjolf has some business to discuss.
Listen, lad. There's one last piece of business we need to settle before we go after Mercer. Carlia and I had a long discussion before you arrived here. Thanks to your efforts, Mercer's treachery has been exposed. As a result, we both feel that you have the potential of replacing Mercer as leader of the Thieves' Guild.
I've been at this game a long time, my friend. A long time. I'm good at what I do, maybe even one of the best. But it's all I know. I've never been one to lead. Never desired it, never cared for it. Don't want it. Well, we have a bit of an errand to run before your coronation, so don't get sentimental on me now. Then it's decided. When this is all over and Delvin's contacts assure me that we've regained our footing in Skyrim, we'll handle the details. Until then, I've been poring over the plans you brought us. Carlia and I will meet you there. Prepare yourself, lad. This will be a fight to remember.
Should have figured Astrid would send you. What gave it away? Yeah, gotta admit that little jester's good with that butter knife. In there, through the door. Some old sanctuary by the looks of it. All right, you convinced me. But I slashed him good. Pretty sure I severed an artery. Don't know what you're gonna find in there. But you can probably just follow the blood. Yeah. Do me a favor and kill that little jester twice, just to make sure.
What is life's greatest illusion? You are not worthy. What is life's greatest illusion?
this. Not an original part of the sanctuary, per se. Let's call it a forced addition. Forced by what? Oh, come and see!
Surrender. Oh, you prefer to listen, eh? Of course, the listener listens. A joke, a funny joke. I get it. Then listen to this. Don't kill me. Let poor Cicero live. Return to the pretender. Tell her I'm dead. Tell her you strangled me with my own intestines. But lie. Yes, lie. Lie and let me live. Do what you will. Cicero has no fight.
Greetings.
Oh my, that's beautiful.
Arnbjorn is safe, and for that you have my thanks. Excellent. Tell you what. Why don't you hold on to Shadowmere a while longer? And now that this Cicero mess has been mopped up, we can get back to the matter at hand, There's just one more target before we strike out at the Emperor. Have you by chance heard of the Gourmet? The Gourmet is scheduled to cook for the Emperor at a special dinner. You'll kill him, steal his writ of passage, and assume the role of Master Chef. Festus has been spearheading this part of the assassination plan. He's close to uncovering the identity of the Gourmet. You should report to him.
But first, you'll need to learn who he is. Assuming, of course, that the Gourmet... You know, maybe I was wrong about you after all. In my, investigations, I came upon this. Seems to be a message from the Gourmet to one Anton Varan. I believe so. Oh. Next, you'll have to... As I was saying... Oh, and if you can, hide his body. Now off with you. Remember, the Markarth Keep. That's where you'll find Anton Varan. Probably cooking up all of the gourmet's recipes, passing them off as his own.
Wait, I...
Heard they're reforming the Dawn Guard. Vampire hunters or something. In the old fort, maybe.
Yes, yes, for the 100th time. I am a Breton. I was born in High Rock, and then I came here. Who are you? What do you want? The gourmet? Never. I don't know what led you here, but nothing will betray my trust. I'll take the secret of the gourmet's identity to my grave. The Dark Brotherhood? Now, wait a minute. Let's not get hasty. Look, his name is Balagor Gronolobe. He's an orc. The gourmet's an orc. Now you'll let me go, right? Okay, all right.
I have to work. Wonderful. Oh, Anton will rip my head.
You're welcome.
Don't mind the dogs. They get anxious when they have a dinner.
What a waste.
The Silverblood family will be hurt.